Hello everyone, this is the key of the all new Audi Q2. This is also the most affordable offering from Audi in India. So we would be driving the car here watching Times of India Auto. Like and share the video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. We try to answer three questions today. The first one: how much practical is this small cube? The second one is, does the two have the genes to be a part of the cube family? And the third one, should you really put your money on Audi Q2 or not? So let's begin with the design. You have that familial design, an octagonal grille. It's completely blacked out. You have the quattro badging right here, Audi logo in the middle. If you take a look at the headlamp cluster, it's a complete LED unit with Y-shaped elements in the middle. Now, this Y-shape has been progressively used right across the body profile. Take a look at the bumper. These honeycomb structure give it a nice shape. The bonnet has strong lines, you see. On one side, you have the line coming from there. It runs across the bonnet. Also in the side profile, you have this nice element which starts from here and it kind of differentiates. It runs right across and meets before the C pillar. The C pillar is blacked out. You have quite a beefy structure, a black panel. The car sits on 17-inch alloys. These are 10-spoke in design, shod with Michelin tires, and the tires are 215/55 section tires. Now, if you see right across, you have strong body cladding over the tires as well. This is what the rear profile looks like. You have the Q2 badging. You have the Q2 badging on the left-hand side. You have the 40 TFSI, which is the nomenclature for the engine, on the right-hand side. On the lower half, you have a twin-tip chrome exhaust. The boot is not electrically adjustable, but you have to manually do it. Now, the space provided here is around 400 liters. I have kept few of my bags and you can see, I would say the space here is decent. You get a couple of boot lights, and again, if you lift it, you get the spare tire. Now let's begin with the back seat. So the car is just over 4 meters in length. So do not expect huge amount of space anywhere, whether you are in the cabin or in the back seat. But what I can tell you is the Audi feels rich and premium. If you look at the kind of material used here, now these are mostly bucket seats, so you tuck into them. You can fix yourself in a very comfortable position. However, I feel the backrest is slightly upright. You get a couple of headrests, and I believe this is a strict four-seater. The fifth person sitting in the middle would feel the squeeze, because firstly, the space is not much, and the second thing, you have a raised central tunnel because this is a quattro four-wheel drive. So you can see that quattro tunnel running right across. In terms of conveniences, you have a couple of micro USB ports, dedicated air conditioning vents for the second room. In the middle, you have an armrest with cup holders, and these seats are 40-20-40 split, so you can tuck down any of them and expand the space accordingly. Now, looking at the exteriors, you might just feel Audi Q2 looks like probably a Volkswagen T-Roc or a Skoda Karoq. These cars have similarities, especially because these are based on the same MEB platform that Volkswagen builds. But one thing is for sure that the feel inside the Audi is much more premium. I'll quickly start the car. Now let's begin with the design. So this is 8.3 inch infotainment screen. Interestingly, this is not touch. Now customers are pampered with touch infotainment screen, which are big, snazzy, and look very premium. So that's kind of a miss here. But you have a rotary dial right in the middle, which helps you go through the features here. Moving on to the driver's display. Now this is information packed. You can see so many of them stacked one after another, but this is still Audi's old interface. It's not updated to the latest one, but I still think this is sufficient, adequate, and it looks modern. Take a look at the steering wheel. This is a multifunction unit. It gets a lot of heft, and you have these buttons on either sides for sound, music, and here you have buttons to toggle through the car controls. Now the car gets a dual zone air conditioning system. Surprisingly, there's no AC vents for the rear passengers. That's kind of a miss here. You have nice elements. You can see these are nice elements which glow at night, give it a nice premium feel. The knobs have a ticking effect, so you rotate them, you have a nice tactile feel. Also, you have the drive select. The car has 5 drive modes. You can switch off the parking sensors and other features here. In terms of storage space, I would say it's not very exhaustive, but you get those basic ones. You have a bottle holder for the door pocket, a glove box which is not very huge but practical. You have a couple of cup holders in the mix. Also, you get a tray here which comes with a wireless charging facility. Now the car also has a sunroof, not very huge, but it gets a sunroof. Now what I don't like about the interior is that couple of things. First, these are leatherized seats, not leather seats, and these are not ventilated. So you can understand the kind of sweating discomfort you might have during Indian summers. Well, the AC is functional, but again, leather seats with ventilation, at least in the top trims, could have been provided. Also, these seats are not electrically adjustable. These have to be manually adjusted. Now the dashboard design, though, has a lot of soft touch material with this interesting bit running right across with quattro badging. But again, at places you might not feel this to be that premium. For example, this one. This one is completely plasticky, I would say. And for example, these aircon vents, these are circular in design. These look slightly dated. However, what I think is that Audi has really done a good job in bringing Q2, though they are a bit late, but they have finally arrived in the entry-level premium segment. So without further wasting any more time, let's get moving. Let's drive the car and tell you how the Q2 feels like on the move and does it live up to the expectation of a Q family or not. Let's get the numbers out quickly before we get to driving the car. Now the Audi Q2 comes in 5 trims. All of them get a 2-liter TFSI petrol engine. All of them are 4-wheel drive, the quattro drive, and the engine is good enough for 190 PS power, 320 Nm of torque, while the engine is mated to a 7-speed DSG gearbox. The 0 to 100 claimed figure is 6.5. So let's get moving and see how much fun is it to to drive the all-new Q2. The first thing I would like to discuss is the dynamics, because you do not sit in this car like a conventional SUV on a high pedestal. Instead, it is a low slung profile as compared to most of the SUVs in the market. However, this low stance gives you a better leverage on the corners. You have lower center of gravity, so you have better grip going around twisties and corners. The visibility out of the driver's place is excellent, I would say. You get a huge windscreen. The outside rear view mirrors are a little bit pushed towards you, so you get a nice window right in the middle, which allows you to have that extra sight while taking a left or a right turn. Now, this 2-liter TFSI petrol engine is strong. It has got a nice thump to it. The torque, however, kicks in slightly later in the rev band. Around 2000, you kind of feel that TFSI engine coming to life. That said, the engine is very, very refined. You do not feel any kind of grumble from the engine, even when you are revving it very, very hard. The 7-speed DSG gearbox is quick to respond. It shifts quickly. But again, if you compare it with the premium segment cars, you might just feel it is a tad bit slow to react. But overall, the 7-speed DSG married with the 2-liter petrol engine is a very good combination for the Audi Q2. Now you get 5 drive modes. When I switch to different drive modes, I feel the car is most exciting to drive in the dynamic mode. Well, you don't get a sports mode with this, but thankfully you have paddle shifters right behind the steering wheel. The steering wheel is also well weighed. It has that nice heft to it. So I think Q2 has those genes of making your ride really sporty, whether you are speeding on the highways or taking quick turns. So the Q2 does retain the charm of Q family in some ways. The Q2 is light-footed, nimble to drive, and what adds to the overall fun is the compact dimension. Now this is not as humongous as other Q family SUVs. In fact, this is the smallest of them all. So what it does is that it helps you really filter through the traffic if you are taking quick turns, twists. I think the compact dimensions help you in the overall game. Now, Audi Q2 comes to India through CBU, or completely built unit route, which means it's going to attract higher taxation rates. On the flip side, what I'm happy to report from behind the driving wheel is that the ride quality is superb. Though it's a European car, it does not give you that hard, firm suspension setup. What also makes the deal even more sweeter is the 17-inch wheels. Now, visually 18 inches would have complemented better, but I think these 17-inch wheels do a good job in ironing out most undulations. Still, if you are hitting a pothole or a crater at lower speeds, you would feel that jerk, but when you are coasting on the highways, you come through something uneven, the car just floats over them. The claimed figure from Audi in 0 to 100 kmph dash for Q2 is 6.5 seconds, but during our test run, the number deviated quite a bit. It took around 7.5 seconds, almost 7.7 seconds to 0 to 100 kmph, which I think is a kind of a miss for an enthusiast.